Yeah, that's when he was in Manoa Park, up at, you know, the nursing
Right.
facility.
For 63 years, Eric Wiley of Cleveland led a full life, 45 of those years with his wife, Dorothy.
Oh, he was a very comical type person. He loved servicing people. He loved feeding and cooking and seeing people happy.
Wiley died in 2010 of a cardiac arrest, his family by his side. An honorable veteran of the United States Army in the Vietnam War, his wife expected funeral director Charles Taylor to have Wiley's ashes interred at a veteran's cemetery.
We had a funeral, and then after that, the cremation. And then the remains were to go to the military slot. I signed papers for that.
But on Tuesday, 3 years after his death, a box with Wiley's cremated remains was discovered thrown out along with two others inside an Akron dumpster. The family's final wishes for him never having been carried out.
We thought everything was taken care of.
And
I mean, it was enough to lose him in the first place, but for someone to just deliberately abuse him in such a way, it was very upsetting.
The funeral director told Fox 8 the cremains had apparently been in a Macedonia storage unit the owner locked him out of after payments were not made. The owner of the unit refused to tell us how they might have ended up in an Akron dumpster, far from the dignified final resting place where Dorothy expected her late husband to have been laid to rest.
Well, that's the worst you can do is dumps. That's garbage. We dump garbage all the time. But you don't do human beings like that, mm-hmm. because we have feelings, we have emotions.